when during the special occasions, when we are chanting, in Govardhan you are chanting when you are feeling it, you also felt that, but this is like not capable of chanting more is different story. But the heart says, no, it's less, we have to go more, we have to progress more. Because it is less. They could only chant 3 lakh Harinam, Prabhupada and Haridas Thakur. They were chanting properly and they are taking time, and then they could do it in that way through beats. And if not like Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj, even when they are in drowsing or even sleeping, then also they are chanting the holy name. That is different story. But with the japa beats, they could only do this much. If they have time and if they could do more, with japa also they will increase the number of rounds. Like that. And again, we coming in that line of Prabhupada, and then we say like how crazy it is. That no, no, chant only 4 rounds, chant only 16 rounds. It is too much. Or in the japa beats, we have one small, you know, small one, 4 here and 16 here. If only 16 rounds or 4 rounds, then why the second thing is there? It doesn't make sense. Once you do chant 16, then you know, 1 down like this. Like that 64, total 64. That is like a minimum number Prabhupada has given. At least chant 64. Our Gurudev also, I remember at the time of our initiation, he said, after you finish chanting 16 rounds, you can pull this one. Like this, how many you chant? At least 64, if possible. In one day, if it is possible. If not, at least 16 should, you should chant 16. That 4 beats are for showpiece, like to look it, make it beautiful. People there are crazy that they say that. What is this? The reason is because they don't understand the importance of Harinam. When Harinam is pleased, we get everything. We get everything. There was one devotee, Haridas Goswami. He was living in Nidwan. Because of him, Banki Bihari appeared. What he was doing? Old man. He was very old. You know this? Banki Bihari temple, have you been to Banki Bihari temple? You? Okay. Banki Bihari temple is in Vrindavan, and Banki Bihari, he appeared in Nidhuvan, Lalita Konda. This very old devotee, Haridas Goswami, he was sitting in the in Nidhuvan, and he is chanting Harinam, singing the kirtans for the Lord. And Lord appeared there like this. He could not remain, and he appeared there, Banki Bihari. And then every day he is singing kirtans for Banki Bihari. And Banki Bihari is only satisfied listening to his japa and his kirtan, nothing else. Later what happened, his disciples, they came to him and they begged. They said, Gurudev, we are like starving. This is self-manifested deity. No one made it. So if you allow us, we'll make nice temple, so that people can come and have darshan, and we get some donations for surviving and all. He felt so hurt in his heart listening to these words. Very sad. What he did? He said, okay, take him. You will get plenty of money, but there won't be any devotion.
Haridas Goswami said.
He said. And they did not pay attention, and they just went and then made beautiful temple in Vrindavan. Later what happened? 2 times Banki Bihari ran away from the temple. 2 times he ran away. Can you imagine? Deity ran away. Next morning when they opened the altar, there is no deity. How deity can run? If he is not the Supreme Lord. He is present. And he ran away. Why? He is being served in a very opulent way. Very amazing kind of Vrindavan means Banki Bihari. People, when you talk about Vrindavan, they don't speak about Radha Damodar, Radha Raman, nothing. They say Banki Bihari.
From Delhi, they go
everywhere.
Yeah.
All the people, whoever comes, when you say Vrindavan, it is only Banki Bihari. And later, this Angrej Mandir is gone. They say that Angrej Mandir, they say like this, is gone. For evening Aarti and all people, they like to go to ISKCON, and here for Darshan, they like to go to Banki Bihari. These are the two places famous in Vrindavan.
I wanted to ask you, because local people, they consider Banki Bihari as main temple, right?
That's what I'm saying. You know, he became very famous. And in a very opulent way, they serve him. Now one time, one devotee, he came. And he looked into the eyes of Banki Bihari. And Banki Bihari started walking behind him, and he went to his village. They brought the deity from far village. I don't remember all those details. But the thing is, this is what happened. Again, they brought him back after a few days. And again, they put the deity, installed the deity in the temple. Second time also, he ran away. That's why, now if you go to Banki Bihari temple, there is always a curtain. Like this, they pull from very this fast, side, very fast like, you know, like this. As long as the altar is open, you will see it, that curtain will not be open for long time. Every 2 minutes or 1 minute they will be doing curtain like this. Because they don't want any devotee to have eye to eye contact with Banki Bihari. That is the reason. Once you have your eye to eye contact with him, and if you are a pure devotee, he will run behind you. What is attracting him? What is attracting? Harinam is attracting. Devotion is attracting. That big temple and opulent services are not attracting. You will not see like this in any temple, only in Banki Bihari. They keep on pulling. 2 persons are always engaged there. As long as the temple is open, they have to pull the curtain and close the curtain. Pull the curtain and close the curtain. Because they don't want anyone to look straight into the eyes of Banki Bihari. He will not remain there. What to do? What he want? He only want that love of the devotee. How it comes? By doing Harinam, by singing the glories of the Lord. And we tell, okay, no need to do this. What is the logic?
When he lived, Haridas Goswami?
I don't know. Many years ago.
1560.
Something like that.
The time of Muslim Banki Bihari also?
No.
He was there?
He was there.
Still, it's original deity.
Of course, it is the original deity. He was there. Akbar, in his kingdom, there was one very good singer. His name was Tansen. You know Tansen? This fellow Tansen, he is the disciple of Haridas Goswami. So Akbar, during the rule of Akbar and all those things, it was very nicely taken care of. So that is the reason in Banki Bihari he remained there. He remained there, nothing, they did not have any problem for that. And also in a very opulent way they serve him. Radha Vallabh, Banki Bihari, both. The thing is, what is attracting? Devotion is attracting. One Mataji came to our Gurudev. She is his god sister.
Gurudev?
Our Gurudev. She came to Gurudev and then she asked for some money. Because one time one disciple of our Param Gurudev, they are very poor. So Param Gurudev mercifully gave her one coin. He gave her one coin and told her, keep this coin with you. She kept that coin in the place where they keep cash. And after that, money started coming and they became very rich. Inspired by this story, one god sister of ours also, and god brother, one god sister and god brother of Gurudev, they went to Gurudev for asking money. They asked. That lady before, she did not ask. Param Gurudev gave by himself. These people, they are inspired, and then they asked Gurudev. Gurudev understood. He gave the coin and he said, you will get money but not devotion. They became very rich. After they became very rich, finally they understood what we have done. They left everything and now they are doing bhajan. The thing is, when we have other desires, when we are involved in other activities, other than Harinam, other than Harikatha, Kirtan, we may progress worldly, but spiritually we will become zero. That is very harmful. Goswami Tulsidas, he says, Sutudhara or Lakshmi Papi ke bhi hai. You know, to have son, to have wife, to have money, everyone can have. There is no such person. Laden also had many wives and many children. No? Laden, Osama bin Laden, he also had many wives and children. The thing is, and Goswami Tulsidas, he says, to have money, to have worldly opulences, name and fame, all those things, wife and children, even a sinful person also, he can have. Papi ke bhi hai. Papi means a sinner, he can also have. Sant samagam harikatha tulasi dullabh dwar. Association with devotees, and then when they come, then also harikatha. Simply only by associating with devotees is not sufficient. It said harikatha, which is very rare. So we should give importance to harikatha in the association of devotees. Instead of that, when we give importance to other things and neglect harikatha, neglect chanting, then we get nothing in our life. Life is useless, meaningless. What is the point? Outside person is also doing the same thing, we are also doing the same thing. Only we put one tag, that devotee, and then we do, that's all. By having this tag, it is not going to help. Of course, when it is a festival, when it is an occasion, when it is our duty, then we can't neglect them to serve the deities, to do all those things. But priority should be given to Harinam also. Yashoda was never churning the butter silently. When she was churning the butter or working in the kitchen or doing any things, then also she is constantly singing the names of the Lord. What happened when Yashoda, she is singing the names of the Lord and she is churning the butter, then it comes into the ears of Krishna. He is sleeping and then he wakes up and then he comes and he holds that stick and says, why? Madhbhakta yatra gayanti tatra tishtami narada. Where my devotees are glorifying, singing my names, I go and I sit there, that's all. I will not move. No need to call him. No need to call him. That is the reason only person who is chanting Harinam never experiences separation from the Lord. If you worship the form and the qualities and the pastimes, all that, there is a possibility of feeling some separation. But if you are chanting the holy name, you will not feel any separation. Because Lord is always there. He is with you. He can't go anywhere else, those who are chanting Harinam. He sits there, that's all. He will sit and then, okay, I am with you. So there is to survive from the pain of separation. Devotees, they chant more Harinam. They sing more Harinam. Harinam is helping them to survive from that pain of separation.
That's why Haridas Thakur said, I cannot chant less than 3 lakhs.
He said, and then he was not even ready to eat anything before he finishes rounds. Mahaprabhu, he brings Jagannath Prasad for Haridas Thakur, and Haridas Thakur, he is not taking because he could not complete his rounds. And Mahaprabhu says, you are Namachari, no need. You can reduce your number. He decided to leave the planet, but he was not ready to. Because if you reduce the number of rounds in that level, that is the biggest pain. That is the biggest misery. Like this. So anyhow, Lord comes and he recites there. He will just sit near the devotee. That's what Lord says. And what Yashoda is doing, if a devotee like Yashoda, she is doing, she is chanting the name of the Lord. How can the Lord remain after that? He could not remain anymore. And then he comes. Like that. So we should, whatever we are doing, yat karosi yadasnasi yat juhosi dadasiyat yat tapasyasi kaunteya tat kurush madarpana. Tat kurush madarpana. Whatever you are doing, everything you have to do, offering it to the Lord. It should be offered to the Lord. All our activities. Meaning, how it is possible? Whatever you are doing, no problem. But if you are chanting constantly, that is not possible. So we have to sit and chant. That is not possible. Gopis, they are doing all their activities, not like they are like frozen. Only Nand and Yashoda, they did nothing because they are crying for Gopal all the time. Gopis, they can't do like that. That they will also not work, do anything, they sit in the home and then keep crying, no? Because according to this Bhaum Leela of Vraj, they are married to some other Gopa. So they have to work. They have to do all those things what they are supposed to do. They were doing everything, engaged in all the activities. But deep in the heart, constant remembrance of Krishna. So much of a pain in separation from Krishna is always there. When it comes out, when they all meet Sajati, devotees, those who are of Sajati, when they come together, when all these gopis, they come to the bank of river Jamuna and then try to fill water, and someone, you know, could not bear it and then chants the name of the Lord, and then it starts there. It's inside. They try to suppress it. And when someone raises the name, immediately everyone starts to burst and speak about Krishna, sing about Krishna, imitate the pastimes of Krishna. They are completely immersed in Krishna, Krishna Bhakti, Ras, the mellow of Krishna Bhakti. Like that. You know, some person who has so much of garbage in the heart, he is like this. And suddenly you try to scratch that person slowly, immediately, you know, you will be like this. And then you can, what you listen from that person, it's only garbage, nothing else. Many years ago, in 2003, 27th December, first time I traveled by flight. It's very exciting.
When Maharaj, in 2003?
27th December was the first time I took flight from Bangalore to Mumbai. And we have one friend, because I don't know what to do in the airport and all, I haven't been before. So one person was with me. He is our godbrother, elderly person. And then he is directing me, we go this way, that way. I said, okay, finally we are in the aircraft. I'm sitting near the window at 11 p.m. in the night. What you will see 11 p.m. in the night, you see nothing, but so excited. So I was sitting in the window, just want to see what's happening. Now I don't like window anyhow. sitting, and then crew is walking here and there. I saw my friend. He is staring at the crew. I understood something is there. So I wanted, like, you know, to poke him. What I did, because we were also very young, just happy to have fun, I just told him, crew is very beautiful. Immediately he said,
come on.
Yes, very beautiful. I said, have some shame, you are very elder person. This mindset is not good. He said, you told me, so I could not control my emotion. Like this, you know, garbage is also like that. We have so much garbage, desires, all those things in the heart. As long as someone is not trying to do like this, everything is okay. The moment something comes, immediately person bursts. In the same way, devotion also. When the people are vijati, those who are anti-devotional, anti-spiritual, those who don't have that similar mood, then devotees also, they reserve themselves. When someone with the same mood comes, immediately there starts Krishna Katha. There starts Krishna Katha, and which is never ending. In the case of Gopi, same thing used to happen. Whole day they are working, they are doing their things, but when they come to river Jamuna, and then someone starts to raise the topic about Krishna, because whatever they see, they always have Udipan. When they see Kadam tree, when they see Jamuna, when they see some Upavan or whatever, everything they see, everything reminds them of Krishna. What to do? If they try to control themselves, then also it is not possible. So someone raises the topic, immediately the discussion starts and everyone are crying, everyone go in trance, everyone are having different body language. They imitate like Krishna, they dance like Krishna, they do so many things there. Why? Because in the heart only Krishna is there. But externally, they had to do so many things. They can't even commit suicide because in the heart Krishna is there. Lord will feel not like it. Always immersed in Krishna Naam, Krishna Naam, Krishna. How difficult it is, not so easy. It's very easy to express your heart, but it is very difficult to have emotions, to have that deep love in the heart and to hide it. It's not easy. They were practicing, they were like, we are trying to practice parakya, that viparlamba bhava. We only can use the words, but we can't even imagine what is vi in viparlamba bhava. And what is pain parakya bhava? Not so easy. But for them, they are in parakya mood, in bhom lila. And also there is this viraha. Parakya is more special than swakya. We will not speak about that. But the thing is, parakya is more special than swakya. And when there is this viparlamba mood together, you can't imagine what would be the life is. Still they are surviving, holding their life to meet with Krishna. Because he said only one word, that I will come to Vraj. I will come. I'll be back.
Hare Krishna.
He said, I'll be back, I will come. Only to meet with him, only to unite with him. With that desire they are holding their lives. And they survived. How painful it is to survive. When Maharaj Janak asked Bharat, what you can do for Lord Ramachandra? I can do anything, I can even die. Can you survive for here? Can you live for here? Which was more difficult. But he lived. How he lived? With the help of the holy name. If there is no holy name, then he would have died long back on. If there is no holy name, gopis would have died in separation from Krishna. Holy name is there. How Sachi Mata survived? Always chanting the name of Gaur Hari. When she is chanting, he is present there. So whatever she is cooking, he is eating. Whatever she wants to do for Gaur Hari, he is accepting everything. But she is thinking, because they are, for the past time, they are covered by yoga maya. So she is thinking, maybe this is my illusion. But she feels him, she experiences him. She offers the plate, everything is there, and then when she goes to the temple, she sees that plate is empty. She thinks, maybe I forgot. Like that. Gopis were also thinking in the same way. That is a different kind of mellow. Their relation. Lord is relation. How it is possible? All through Harinam only it is possible. Without that it is not possible. Vishnupriya, how she survived? Every day chanting Harinam, every day chanting Harinam and taking one grain. Whole day you chant Harinam with one grain of rice, and evening how much it will be? If we do like that, how much it will be? Maximum like only this much?
Even less.
Whatever. And half she is offering again to cow or Ganga, this, that, whatever, to the devotee, and remaining half she is eating. How much she is eating to survive? Raghunath Das Goswami, only just taking one small cup of buttermilk, he is surviving. He is surviving with that, he is surviving. How he is surviving? Without the holy name. Like this. Devotees, they survive with holy name. The most painful thing in their life is only separation from the Lord. Separation comes when there is relation, sambandha. There is no separation. If we cry, Sesandana Paya Kande Yeyadam Das, doesn't make any sense. In that kirtan, Sesandana Paya Kande Narottam Das, only Narottam Das can cry. Gurudev can cry. Param Gurudev Prabhupada can cry. We can't. We don't have that sambandha. Relation is not there. When there is relation, then there is the feeling of separation. When there is separation, then only it can be felt. Like that. That comes through chanting. Now separation for Harinam is also not there. If we are sick, or if we are busy, and anyhow some people are very kind, they say just chant 2 rounds, 4 rounds. So they are at least chanting, they don't feel any separation. Okay, 4 rounds I can do it, and then okay. Then what we will get? Ultimately we get nothing. No taste for anything and no attainment, anything. That's why many times we lose our faith, we get disturbed. All these things happen in our life. Harinam is that cheap that person can lose their faith. The thing is, we never had developed any kind of faith for Harinam. Not like something like this world. If we lose faith in Harinam, means the words of Mahaprabhu will become wrong. Mahaprabhu says, Anandam Budhi Vardhanam. When you chant the holy name, what is happening? This ocean of bliss is keep on increasing. And those who try to relish it, they are also relishing Purnamrita. complete nectar. And we are losing faith if we are not attentive. Means we haven't started. That we have to understand very clearly. It can be 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, 100 years, or 200 lives also. If I sincerely start to chant, then definitely Lord reciprocates and I can feel that reciprocation. I can experience the reciprocation of the Lord. That Lord is reciprocating for my chanting of the holy name. When Meghna tried to release arrow on Lakshman, when they both were fighting, and then he tried to release arrow on him, what happened? He faints. Who is crying? Lord Ramachandra is crying. Lakshman is not crying. And his wife Urmila is also not crying. When she comes to know, she is also not crying. What she says? Actually, my husband is safe. She says, she is living in Ayodhya and she says that my husband is safe. Why? Actually, the arrow, it hit Lord Ram, not to my husband. Lakshman is fully covered with the armor of the holy name. So it did not attack him. Like that. Holy name acts like in that way. It embraces the devotee. And the devotee is fully protected and taken care by the holy name. She also feels this. How difficult it is, but they make it very easy. Why? Because they are lost in the holy name. They are chanting and they are lost in the holy name. Even in that separation also, externally, physically, they see that Srimati Radhika has become very weak. But what she says that I don't understand what taste is hidden in the holy name. That when I chant this holy name, it makes everything inert, pacifying my ears, my heart, and then it makes everything inert and I feel so satisfied. In separation also. So it's very important to engage more time, more energy in the chanting of the holy name. Then the result can be seen. Then the result can be seen. See Yashoda and the Sakhas, all of them, their mood also did not change. In Kurukshetra, when they all come, Yashoda is calling Gopal and Krishna appears in front of her in the form of Gopal only. Their mood is not changing. Their intensity of devotion is not changing. What was her age? 100 years of separation. And around the age of 80, something like that, she had Gopal. Yashoda, when she came to Kurukshetra, she also had like 180 years or something. Old lady, how can she call the name of the Lord from there? And there is a very huge compound and big, big gates are there. Whatever way possible, she is trying to call and it reaches the Lord and Lord jumps from the throne. And then he immediately comes to Mother Yashoda. Holy name attracts. Abhinnatvat namnami. The holy name and the named both are non-different from each other. When we chant, then only we attract Krishna. If Krishna is not there, all these opulences, for what is the use of them? Whom we will serve? If we want to serve the Lord, whom we will serve? We have so many opulences, but there is no Lord. Like that. When there is such a big temple in Jagannath Puri of Lord Jagannath, when Jagannath comes out, how many people have so much of excitement or interest in going to that main temple. Now people are more interested to go to Gundicha temple. That is very small as compared to the temple of Lord Jagannath. But people, you can find huge, huge rush in Gundicha temple, but not in the main temple. You can easily go to the main temple after that. What is the in priority? The huge, big size temple and all these things are priority. Importance is of Lord Jagannath. And now when Jagannath comes back from Gundicha temple to the main temple, how many people in a year would like to go inside Gundicha temple and then sit and spend time or do something there? Everyone rushes to the main temple. Who is in priority? Jagannath is in priority. Holy name is in priority. When Lord is there, opulences have some meaning. If Lord is not there, nothing has any meaning. So Lord, how he comes? He is attracted by the holy name. Radha Vinod, Loknath Goswami, with one cloth like this, he made a knot and he was hanging the deities and then he is going everywhere. People, they told him, we will make one small hut for you, you can keep the deities here and serve. He said no. He wanted to hang them on his neck. You go to Radha Gokulanand temple in Vrindavan, you can see the deities. They are not very small deities, like this big size. And he made one bag and then he hanged around his neck and then he is doing his japa and he is going. Wherever he is going, keeping them and then serving them, again keep them in that bag and then he is going. And Radha Vinod, they are very happy. Radha Vinod, both are very happy there. Most safest place for them. Why? We make so many big temples, so many things. Where? What is Vaikuntha? Where there is no anxiety, where there is no dispute, where there is no differences of opinion, where there is only peace, everything. So above Vaikuntha, all those abodes which are there, everywhere there should not be any anxiety. There should not be any stress. And Srila Prabhupada says that where deities are there, that part doesn't belong to this world. It is Vaikuntha. Then why we are not happy? Either the place is not Vaikuntha, or Prabhupada is not saying correct words, or something is wrong. When we think all these things, the answer comes that I was never serious in my life, in my sadhana. That's it. This is the hard truth which we don't want to accept. But it is the truth. When if you are a devotee, there is no anxiety. There is no misery. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he says, Atma Nivedan Tuya Pade Kori Hoinu Param Sukhi. I surrendered to your lotus feet. Immediately I became happy. How I surrendered to the lotus feet of the Lord? Through chanting of the holy name. When the moment I took shelter in the lotus feet of the holy name, immediately I became very happy. What is your lotus feet? Ashok Abhay Amrit Adhar Tamar Charan Dvai. Ashok, there is no place for any misery. Abhay, no fear. Amrit, only nectar. So holy name is like this. Our fear is not gone. Misery is not gone. It is only increasing. Interesting that misery is increasing. And then what? Forget about nectar. If we feel it as nectar, then we would not be able to leave it for a moment. Amrit Adhar, Tomar Charan Dvai, your lotus feet. Where is the feet? Where is the holy name? তাহাতে এখন বিশ্রাম লাভিয়া ছাড়িনু ভবের ভয়ে। When I got the shelter in those lotus feet of yours, what happens? Chhadinu bhaver bhai, I have given up the fear of this material world. There is no fear anymore now. There is no fear anymore. How it is happening, how all this is happening? When we are seriously connected to the holy name. So the problem is, we did not chant nicely. And also Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Tumar sevai dukh hoyat sevto param sukh. While serving, while chanting Harinam, if we experience some misery, that is also param sukh, is the highest of happiness. So where is that happiness? Where is that happiness? I'm chanting but I don't feel happy. Means I am not chanting properly. Lord is not there, life is not there, lifeless chanting. Understand? Very disappointing, Harikatha.
Yes.
Yes? Very disappointing.
Why?
No hope.
It destroys your ego. If it seems you have achieved something, now you understand there is nothing. You should put more effort.
So like this, very important to understand. If we stay in darkness, then how we will understand? Blindly, if I keep on walking, one day I will fall in pit. I should not be blind. I have to keep my eyes wide open. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Sev to param sukh. I am very happy, no problem. You can see all these gopis, Vrajvasis, everyone, even though they are experiencing so much of misery in separation from the Lord, still they were only feeling happiness. They are very happy. They are very happy. Seva sukha dukha param sampad. While performing this devotional service, whatever comes, both are param sampad, at a highest treasure. Even the happiness and the distress which comes in serving the Lord is highest treasure. A different flavor of that highest treasure. Being happiness or being unhappy, whatever it is just a flavor. And that misery is also giving so much of taste, bliss. Why Srimati Radhika says, More yadi diya dukh tar hoy mahasukh. Say sukh, more sukh hoy. Something like that. You remember? Anyhow. If I feel in misery, if I am in misery, if Krishna wants to give me misery, and by giving misery to me, He is happy. His happiness is my happiness. So I am happy to be in misery for the pleasure of Krishna. Why? There is, it's like, what is this? How can a person be happy in misery for the pleasure of his beloved when the person is not fully attached or immersed in the name, form, qualities and pastimes of the beloved? It is not possible. So how many years we are chanting, that is not the thing which is counted. How deeply we are chanting, that is really counted. How sincerely we are chanting, that is counted. Ek Krishnam kare sar papakshay. Only one name of Krishna. Gokoti Danam Grahanena Kala Prayaga Kashi Kritakalpavasa. Sumeru Tulyam Suvarna Danam and Govinda Nama Pi Kadapi Tulyam. No? What is that word? Anyhow, understand the thing. Gokoti Danam Grahanena Kala, at the time of eclipse, if you are donating millions of cows, what benefit you will get? And the size of Sumeru mountain, that much of gold if you are donating. And in Prayag and Kashi, if you are living in Prayag and Kashi, you are making this Kalpavas, living in the month of Magh and all those things with severe austerities, taking bath 3 times a day and then doing severe austerities. Even the 16th part of the holy name also, it is not equal. That is the holy name. That is the glory of the holy name. And when we chant that name, then Lord is attracted. He is attracted and He comes. When He comes, when the Lord comes, bliss is coming, happiness is coming, mellow is coming. Not just you will be happy, you will be in bliss. No. There is mellow. Rasa is there. That keep on increasing and you are relishing it. Relishing, relishing, relishing. Then life is saved. Then life is saved. If not, who will save the life? No one can save us. So don't listen to those people who say chant 4 rounds or 2 rounds or 3 rounds. No. We have to chant more and more and more. Everyone survived only through Harinam only. Prahlad also survived because of Harinam. Prahlad survived because of Harinam, he survived. He was not, he could not survive. He was chanting the name of the Lord. Jaydev Goswami, Rupa Sanatan Goswami, Gopal Bhatt Goswami, all these Goswamis, Prabhupada, Haridas Thakur, everyone they survived only through Harinam. So we should also pay attention in chanting of the holy name. If not, life will become disaster. Spiritual disaster in spiritual life is not good. Disaster in material life, it's okay, no problem. But disaster in spiritual life is very bad. It's not good. Because we are making in this material life, it is our prarabdha. Very much possible whatever happens, it is because of our prarabdhas in this material world. But in this spiritual world, whatever is happening, it is we ourselves, we are making those disasters. Not because of prarabdha our spiritual life is finished. It is our own deed. Whatever happens in this material world, that is because of our prarabdha karma. And whatever is happening in the spiritual practice, that is what we are doing now. Because of prarabdha karma, we will not get devotion. We get devotion through sadhu sangha. Bhakti astu bhagavad bhakta sangena parijayate. Bhakti, devotion, comes only in the association of pure devotees. Satsanga prapyate pumbhi sukritai purva sanchitai. And that association with the devotees is coming through the Sukruti. Through Sukruti. whatever sukritis we have performed till the last minute of our life helps us to get sadhu sangha. And through sadhu sangha we get devotion. So that's why very important that spiritual life should not be a disaster. For that we have to pay attention. In sadhu sangha, we have to pay attention in following the instructions of the sadhu. We have to pay attention towards the chanting of the holy name. Then we see the result. After that, even if we do one harina, then also it can be a shuddha nama. Right, also it can be a shuddha nama. Pure name.
Can be. Possible, possible.
Yes, possible. Possible. It not it will be, it can be. Like that. We were listening yesterday, we were discussing about this person Dundukari. You know the name Dundukari? You heard the name? Nice man. So this Dundukari, what kind of person he was? He doesn't have any good quality. He's a very bad person. Bhanumati, you heard the name Dundukari? He's good boy. He don't have any good quality. Very dangerous. He was so dangerous that the city was scared of him. And king always, king wants to catch him. And people, they don't want to walk out of from his home, in front of his home. Or also don't want to go anywhere in the night because they are so scared, they don't know when he will catch. He can kill or he can loot, he can do anything. They never know. That Dundukari, what happened? He brought his five prostitutes and kept them in his home. Because of his behavior, father ran away from home. He could not stay in the home anymore after that. Okay, what happened next? Mother jumped in the well because he was beating mother also. Such a kind of dirty person he was before, bad person. He was beating mother and then asking for money, like a dacoit, looting money from the people, creating so much of disaster. And finally, these whatever you perform, your action, reaction comes in the same way. What happened? These five prostitutes, two were holding his feet, two were holding his hands, body like this. And one with big stone smashed his face and killed him. So that they don't identify him. No one identifies him. They beat with the stone. Why? Because king wants to catch him. If king catches him, not only him, all these five prostitutes will be punished. So they thought, we take whatever money he have and we kill him, we can at least settle our life. And they just killed him, took all his money and then they all left. Now he became ghost, Brahmadaitya. He became Brahmadaitya because he is a Brahmin person, very coming from a religious family, very nice family. But because of his deeds, he became ghost, so he became Brahmadaitya. Not an ordinary ghost, very dangerous ghost. Ordinary ghosts, you know, they are more kind sometimes. But these Brahmadaityas are very dangerous. Like this. So Brahmadaitya can go even into the altar room also. Brahmadaityas, they are capable of going into the altar room. They are very, very powerful. Like that. Like people like me, if I commit suicide, I will become Brahmadaitya. So like this, someone will kill me, I'll become Brahmadaitya. Like this, you know, those who are...
If somebody kills, not only when suicide, if somebody kills, you
Like everyone who's killed like in such a terrible way.
No, you are not fortunate to be Brahmadhan. You will be a small ghost. So, like, you know, those who are performing austerity, those who are renunciates, those who are the priests, those who are orthodox brahmanas, like those who are like on different level, like those who are coming from those families, such people, in exceptional cases, they become brahmadetyas. So anyhow, they can go to the altar rooms and they can go anywhere. And you can't chant any mantra or anything to pacify them. That is not possible. A very, very, very strong personality is needed who can deliver brahmadaitya. Ordinary persons, they can't do. And normal sadhu, like I can't save a person who is haunted by brahmadaitya. Small ghosts I can help. But if a brahmadaitya is haunted, then not possible for me. Because that fellow is more powerful than me. Like that. Brahmadaityas are like that. That's why Madhusudan Maharaj, he don't like me if I like to do something like this. He is worried that if it is Brahmadaitya, what will happen? So anyhow, I don't go also. But to understand. And now he became very dangerous. He became very dangerous. And after that, what happens? His brother, he comes, Gokarna. He is a very pious, very spiritual person. He comes back from the pilgrimage and he is sleeping in his house. And in the night, he sees different things happening. He says, "Who is that?" He is not scared. He says, "Who is that?" Then Dundukari, he says, "It is me. What happened to you?" Like this, he said the whole incident. "Oh, sir, please do something so that I am delivered. I am suffering." He said, "Okay, don't worry." Then Gokarna, he went to Kashi. He went to Gaya and made his Shraddha ceremony. He did everything for him. Donations, feast, everything. And finally came back home, and when he was resting, Dundukari, he comes and says, "I am such a big sinner that all these things are not going to help me. These things are not going to help me. You have to find some other way." He said, "What to do?" Then he start to worship sun god. Then sun god appeared and he told him, "The best way to liberate your brother is to speak Bhagavad Katha. You just speak Bhagavad and ask him to listen." And sun god gave him instructions how to keep on bamboo like this, like that, all those things, instructions were given. And that, because Dundukari needs some place where he can sit, he doesn't have any gross body now. So if he doesn't sit, how he will listen? So he told him where to put, how to put everything, and whole village they gathered there. Whole village gathered there, because such a bad person, what will happen to him? We have to see now. And Gokaran, on the fine day, he start to speak Bhagavat. Every day one knot from that bamboo stick is broken. On the seventh day, Dundukari is liberated and he attained the form of the associate of Vaikuntha. Chaturbhuj Rup, he has four hands nicely like Vishnu Dutas, he attained that form. And then from Vaikuntha, Vishnu Dutas, they came to receive him. Now village people were so disappointed. The people of the village were so disappointed. They said, this is injustice. It's injustice. Why? We all are very nice people, very religious people, devotee. And also we came daily for Harikatha, listening very nicely. But only this fellow who is very bad. He is not good, his nature is very bad. How, what kind of life he was living? And you people come to take him. You people come to take him. This is injustice. Then what Vishnudutas they say? They said, only person who heard Harikatha is Dunduka. He was the only person who was listening Harikatha. None of you were listening Harikatha. Yes. Some came to listen, some came to see, some came to do something. You people were not attentively listening to Harikatha. That is the reason you are not liberated. But he was listening very attentively, even though such a bad person in a ghost condition, and also he became a ghost. Then also, when he was paying attention to Krishna Katha, immediately he was liberated. No need, that a very long practice is needed. Sincerely, attentively, if we start with one name, then also life becomes successful. Why not happening in our life? Because Dundukari is much better than that. He is nice. He was giving attention to Harikatha. And after that, all the people of the village, they again did Bhagavat. They told Gokarna, please speak again. He said, okay. Then they start, he starts to speak Harikatha again. Now the whole village is liberated. Only Gokarna remained. Because Vishnudutas, they told him, you have to wait for some more time because through you, many people need to be liberated. You have to liberate many people. So you please stay for some more time. So he was sending people fast. Go. I will come. Like this. Only listening one time. Attentiveness is delivering the person. Chanting only once sincerely. Delivering the person. Remembering the Lord sincerely is delivering the person. What Prahlad did, Smaran Bhakti. He is fortunate to remember because his mother Kayadu, she received benediction from Narad Goswami that whatever she heard, everything will be remembered by her son. He will be remembered by her son. You remember, but if you don't it's in your memory, but if you don't, what you call it?
Discuss.
If you don't make smaran, then how it is possible? Prahlad Maharaj, he did this smaran all the time he was doing, what he remembers, what is his in memory. As a result, Lord manifested. Lord himself, in the glorification of Prahlad, he says, Tvat samo nasti madhavakta bhuvanat praya. In three words, I don't see any devotee equal to you, in all three words. Who says this? Lord himself says this about Prahlad. Why? What he did? What he bribed the Lord? What he gave him, small boy, only chanting. And Lord feels indebted for that, for that devotion. He feels indebted and he gives everything, he bestows everything. Lord himself says to Prahlad that, I am very sorry, I am too late, forgive me. Why you have to say sorry? Because of his devotion. Lord is never late from his side. We are only late. And if we don't pay attention, one day we will be late. Understand? What late? Late in front of the name of the person. You understand? Those who died, they put late in the front of their name. Here what you put, I don't know. In India, when it late is written in front of any person's name, means he is dead. So if we are late, we will be late. That is what we have to understand.
Late such and such. Покійний такий-то, такий-то.
Okay, they understood?
Yes, now.
Okay, good.
I don't apply anything like that.
Whatever that to understand, I'm saying, like that. So, very important. Every day, what we have to do with our sadhana, we have to do this self-introspection. We have to go inside our own heart and see and check the quality of our bhajan. We have to check, not others will check. We have to check what is the quality of my bhajan. How I am doing my bhajan? Is my bhajan going properly or not? Does my heart starts to change or not? What is my condition? And then try to improve it, try to make it better. If I try to make it better, then I can progress. If I don't try to improve it, wherever I am, I will just remain there only. Days will be passing, time will be passing, and we will be hearing so much of Harikatha from different people, different Vaishnavas. But the effect of that Harikatha will not be seen in our life. We will remember for some time, some words, some things. But when it comes to the realization, we will fail in our life. We'll fail. You know, smoothly when life is going, that's not special. When we see some hurdles in our life, and during that condition, if we can see that our bhajan is still stable, means we should understand, okay, I think I started to do bhajan.
When bhajan is stable?
When we see, like, you know, there are, life is about ups and downs in this
waves.
World, waves, in this material world.
Mm-hmm.
So when our bhajan is stable in those conditions of ups and downs, then we should understand that I am practicing. I started practicing.
It's a good sign.
It's a good sign. So we have to see like that. If I can't be happy in the shelter of Sri Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, if I can't be happy chanting the holy name, I should understand that I can never be happy anywhere in the whole world, in three worlds also. Indra is not happy. What to talk of Indra? People want to go to heaven, and when, tell me one time when Indra was happy. He was never happy. Always something is there. He always wants something. He is always worried. He is always in anxiety. He is supposed to be the god of the mode of goodness. But he himself is not happy. How can we imagine that living in this world we can be happy when Lord says, Dukkha Layam Ashashvatam? This world is the place of misery only. Dukkha Layam and Ashashvatam. Momentary, everything is changing. When there is change, when there is misery, how a person can be happy? Anyhow, we can't be happy in this world. It's totally foolish to search for the happiness in this world. When we try to search happiness in the Lord, in His holy name, then this world appears very beautiful. Because this world is created by the Lord. So whatever is His creation, it can't be dirty. It is very beautiful. But when we try to see this creation with the desire to enjoy, then this place appears more dangerous. When we try to see this world through the vision of devotion, then this world appears very beautiful. As long as we survive in this world, we can survive very happily. We will not be affected by anything happening in this world. Everything appears very beautiful, very peaceful, very nice. One person says the world is full of peace, love and harmony. Is it? If we have devotion, then it is. If we don't have devotion, then nothing can be peaceful. Even in the living in the lap of the Lord also, we can't be peaceful. Like that. In the most safest place of all three worlds, sitting there also we will become restless only. If we don't have devotion. If we have devotion, even in the hell also, we can be happy. Vaishala Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Pasu Pakshi Hoye Thaki Swargeva Nirahe. You can make me the bird, or you can make me an animal. No problem. I have no problem. Swargeva Nirahe. If you want to keep me in heaven. If you want to keep me in the hell. No problem. I am happy everywhere. How boldly he says. But what I want, wherever you want to keep me, no problem. One thing I want, that is Tava Bhakti, Rahu Bhakti, Vinoda Hridaye. Your devotion should remain in the heart of Bhakti Vinoda. That is what Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. When there is Bhakti, what is happening? A Bhakti, if a person is having Bhakti, what is happening? Bhagavan is attracted. Bhakti is the wealth which is possessed by a bhakta. And the Lord says, such bhakta attracts my heart. They attract my heart. So when you are in the hell, if you are a devotee, if you have devotion, Lord is with you in the hell also. Where Lord is there, how anything inauspicious can happen? Nothing inauspicious can happen there. Only everything is auspicious. Again, we have to put question. Then why I don't see everything auspicious? Because haven't started yet. See, forget about bhav bhakti and prema bhakti. It is too high. Sadhan bhakti, let's take sadhan bhakti. Let us think that we have shraddha. Let us think. Okay. What we are losing by thinking? At least we are feeling happy. Ignorance is bliss. So let us think. We have nice Shraddha. Very nice. And as a result of Shraddha, we have Sadhu Sangha. We have Sadhu Sangha. And now, what happened? Sadhu means Gurudev very mercifully gave us Bhajan Kriya. And we are sincerely following Bhajan Kriya. Very sincere. So what should happen now in this state? Klesha Agni Shubhadhama. If we are sincerely performing this bhajan, what should happen? Klesha Agni Shubhadhama. Means all these threefold miseries should disappear. and everything auspicious should happen. We should not be affected by the miseries caused by other entities. Others should not hurt us. If others try to hurt us, then also we should not be affected. Tell me, it is happening. So it is sadhana bhakti. Is it sadhana bhakti? In sadhana bhakti, when we are performing sadhana bhakti, the result of sadhana bhakti is kleshagni shubhava. As the result of bhav bhakti is moksha laguta krit sudurlabhana. The result of prema bhakti is sandrananda visheshatma sri krishna karshanichasa. This is the result. So forget bhav and prem, we only talk about sadhana. When we are performing sadhana, we should feel, our sadhana should make us realize what kleshagni is specified. Misery is caused by the nature, adi daivikta, that should not be there. We are very much affected by so many things in the nature. And also misery is caused by other living entities. Someone says something, we feel affected here very deeply. It becomes very difficult after that to tolerate. If we have some injury on our physical body, no problem, that will disappear. After some time that will disappear. But if someone says something, if we have some pain in the heart, that will never disappear. Even after 50 years also he will say, you know, 50 years ago such and such place this thing happened to me. So deeply affected. Very sadhana. And also misery is caused by our own mind and body. Mind is so disturbed. Body is disturbed, so many things are disturbed. So much of disturbance. We are doing sadhana and we talk about the bhav. When a person is in bhav, what? So many things come in his life. Kanti, avyartha kalatvam, virakti, manasunyata, ashabandha, samudkantha, namagani, sadaruchi. All these things will appear in that person. Where are they all? And again we make a layer saying that I am devotee. That is a kind of ignorant cover which we try to cover ourselves. Most important is how I can focus on chanting. Then only Shraddha will come. Then Shraddha will come. Assuming, we can assume anything that I am Prema Bhakta, I am Uttama Bhagavat, who is going to, you know, like, who cares? There are always a fool, though they understand a foolish person as Uttama Bhagavat, or an ignorant person, or a realized person, anyone. Because they don't have brains. You should go inside your heart and let the heart speak. Let Krishna speak. Let the Lord choose for you. When the Lord chooses, He will always choose the best. So we have to give the chance to the Lord to choose what is best for us. And that comes and comes and comes only through the chanting of holy name. There is no other way. There is no other way. There is no other way. Thank you very much. We did not even do Jai Dwani Mangalacharan. Keep on speaking. What is this? Hare Krishna. We'll do some kirtan and then we'll stop for today. It's, yes. we have to understand that this is not about disappointment. This is about inspiration. This is very important that we should take it as an inspiration. When we take this as an inspiration, then our practice will become more beautiful. Oh, I have to do it attentively, I have to do it carefully. But if we say, are you very disappointed, what to do, then it is not correct. Disappointment in sadhana is not good. However, if we don't take it seriously, then tomorrow what disappoints us, that will completely throw us away from devotion. So if we become attentive today, if we become careful today and try to change ourselves a little and practice nicely, then that will help us to progress in devotion. So these things we have to understand in a very positive way, that actually this is for my spiritual benefit, that this will help me to progress in my sadhana. I should not live a life or lead my life blindly or ignorantly. I have to lead my life sincerely, devoted to the words of Sri Guru and Vaishnava. Then I will progress in my bhajan. Surdas, he says, Guru ke vachan atal kari manahi sadh samagam bhije. Atal means it is not changing, you know, like very, you have to take them like dhruv. What is dhruv? In a way, in that way, you have to accept the words of Sri Guru and Vaishnavas and do sadhu sangha. Then you can see how life is changing. Then we can see the miracle. Then we can see the beauty of devotion. Then we can see the sweetness of devotion. Everything is seen very easily. If first move, if I write 2 plus 2 is 5, after that if I try to calculate 2000 or 20,000, my mathematics will be wrong. After that I try to make good calculation. But the problem is, first move was wrong. Is carelessly the move I make in the beginning ultimately leads me to the wrong path. So we have to be very careful in our sadhana and chant very attentively only for the pleasure of Sri Guru Gauranga. Then only we can see how the life is transformed. Thank you very much.